struggles with the unknown while Callum continues to pull Chris's strings in Shortland Street.
Look, I'm a doctor. You might want to pop across the road. Did you get?
No, it's fine. But thank you. I might see the most beautiful girl in the world, and you might see an ugly chick, and who am I to tell you you're wrong? And that, ladies and gentlemen, is where we believe.
Am I really that hideous to you?
What?
Why are you doing this to me? Do you hate me that much?
Sit down.
No!
Scarlett, this isn't about you.
Yes, it is. I'm ugly. I know it, you know it, and everybody else knows it now in the world, don't they?
Just calm down.
Shut up! Shut up!
Talk about losing it.
Ugly skank!
Okay, settle down.
Hey, that's Hunter's.
Don't worry. He'll be thanking me. This is just too precious to miss.
Don't.
Gotcha.
Hey, come on. It's okay. It's...
It's all right, mate. Just passed out for a bit.
Where am I?
Do you remember what happened? Ambulance, please. Yeah, I need an ambulance. The IV bar, it's hot. That's the one. Yep, male, late 20s, having a convulsion. Okay, thank you. Bye.
Where's my phone?
Caitlin's got it.
Please call me Scarlett, and I don't care what time it is. Well, car's gone, phone switched off.
Let's go to a place then.
And do what? Well, say sorry for a starter. That's gonna wash.
You are sorry, aren't you?
Of course I am. So what you were saying was about Scarlett then, in your speech. I was trying to make the point that looks don't matter.
Easy for you to say, supermodel.
Reckon. Hey, you understood my argument. You were sitting there smiling and nodding. You have no idea how it feels to be a loser. You're with the in crowd. You say who's in the in crowd. You'll never know what Scarlett goes through. Or me. Well, I might not say it very often, but Scarlett's got a lot going for her.
Except she's gone a bit la-la.
Oh, I should have seen it coming. I should have done something. Done what? I rewrote my own speech. Yeah, but you got the idea from me. I mean, even the ugliest person in the world is beautiful to someone. I just wanted to win, that's all.
I blame Caitlin Owens. If it wasn't for her, no one would have laughed and Scarlett wouldn't have blubbed everywhere.
We could be here all night worrying about whose fault it is, but what we need to do now is fix it. Yeah, but how?
Now, I want to run a few tests. Bloods, CT scan, see if we can't find out why you had the seizures, okay?
No, you don't have to do that, mate. I'll be all right.
Well, I'll better to be on the safe side.
Yeah, look, it's just some leftover hurts from an old motorbike accident.
Yeah, but I saw you that time in the pub, remember? You lost the strength in your hand.
Yeah, they said to expect some dizzy spells as a result from the concussion.
Who's that?
The doctors in Thailand.
Did they do a CT scan? Did they rule out epilepsy, a brain contusion, an underlying neurological condition? Maybe we should contact your family.
I don't want any more tests. I've been through all that and I'm fine.
Right.
Look, the good doctors in Thailand did their job. They ran their test, they gave me the all clear and they sent me home. They even gave me some medication to help with the seizures.
What's it called?
Salazin.
You see, that could be the problem right there. We just need to run a few tests.
Thank you, but no.
Well, I can't force you to stay.
Right, then. I appreciate your help, but I'll be fine.
Just take it easy, okay? Don't rush things.
Justine should be slaughtered by the DHB, but you go in and save her butt. What I want to know is, what's wrong with my butt?
That was a totally different situation.
My situation, a beefed up racial harassment case, completely unfounded. Justine's, she nearly cost a patient his life.
I had to do what I had to do.
Yeah, I know exactly why. Your precious surgical department, the lowly nursing department, doesn't get a look in.
It wasn't like that at all.
I need another coffee.
Tony, I was hoping to catch you alone.
Really?
Yeah, there's something I want to run past you. Do you think we could meet up a little later? Don't mention it to your husband. I want to see what you think first.
Intriguing.
Okay, meet at my exam room, say 9.
See you then.
Great. Thank you.
Another latte, thanks.
Next time, ask.
You won't be so grumpy once you see the perks.
Delete them.
No, they're award-winning. Take a look.
Not interested. I just want to forget the whole thing.
And please don't talk to Scarlett today. Don't even look at her. Don't do anything.
What is your problem? You're not exactly her best friend.
I'm asking too.
And me.
Oh, you guys are so boring.
Caitlin gives head.
Wearing thin, buddy. Wearing thin.
I know it's a stretch, Caitlin, but just try and act normal for one day.
Okay, I'll back off then. From now on.
Oh, it's too late. Everyone will know by now.
Don't worry, she'll get over it. She'll make it.
Tony. Scarlett!
Go after her.
Punctuality as well as beauty and brains.
As much as the ego likes the flattery, I doubt that's why I'm here.
No. Okay, let's get down to business. I need a clinic manager. Someone that takes care of budget control, can deal with funding applications, and give hands-on patient care when required.
And you want me to sweet-talk Chris or something?
I want you to sweet-talk yourself, honey. Page 10 for the money side of things.
Me, clinic manager?
Well, why not? I heard you're an excellent nursing manager.
From who?
People who count. And quite frankly, I think Chris was a fool for letting you go.
Thank you.
So, no inter-staff politics, just you, in control, all-powerful. You'll be dealing with TK, who is easy on the eye, the ladies tell me.
Okay, okay.
So you'll do it?
I'll definitely have a good think about it.
I think we'd work well together, Tony. I have a feeling we have a lot in common. Mm-hmm.